Hello student, today we are going to solve the linear block example. For example, suppose we have to calculate the 6 by 3 linear block and the generator matrix G is given. In this example, the G is given as 1 00 101 010 011 001 110. So this is the first half of G is nothing but the identity matrix, because there is a 1 in the diagonal and the next one is the parity matrix. We have to find the corresponding all code words, minimum humming distance, error detection and correction capability, probability check matrix, and the error if the received code word is 10011. First of all, identify the identity matrix and parity matrix. In the example, the G is given where identity matrix can be identified where in the diagonal there is a 1 and upper diagonal part is 0 and the lower diagonal part is 0. So we can call it as identity matrix. So this is the identity matrix 3 by 3 and remaining is nothing but the parity matrix. Here the N is given as a 6 and K is given as a 3. So 2 by 3, 2 raised to K or 2 by 3, 2 raised to 3 is nothing but the 8 code words can be calculated. And the total length of the code word should be the 6. Because total length of the block code is N, where M is the message bit and P is the parity bits. So P is equal to N minus M. And PC or the code word is inform message bits multiply into parity bits. So if your message bits is multiplied to the identity matrix, you will get only the message bits. So no need to multiply the message bit by the identity matrix. You simply multiply the message bits by the parity bits only. So your code word can be calculated as a D into G. D is nothing but the message bit and G is nothing but the generator matrix. So message bit should be multiplied or modulo to added with the parity bits only, not through the identity matrix. Okay, so if the message D bit is multiplied to the identity matrix, then the same message will be generated. So let us take the example. Suppose your the code, you can extract the codes C1 to C8 for the 000 to the 111. So let us take the C1 code for the calculation. 000, so 000 multiplied by the parity bits. So 000 multiplied by the parity matrix. So 0 multiplied by 1, so it is 0. XOR with 0 multiplied by 0, it is 1. 0 XOR with 1, it is 0. So all you will get the zeros. So no need to do the calculation. So C1 will be the 3 message bits, 000 and 3 parity bits as you get. Okay, so calculate the C2 words. So 001 and parity bits. So 0 multiplied by 1, 0, 0 multiplied by 0, 0, 1 multiplied by 1, this 1, 1. So do the XORing or modulo to addition. So from this you will get the 1. Next again, 0 multiplied by 0, again it comes 0, 0 multiplied by 1, 0, and 1 multiplied by 1, so 1. So you will get the 1. In the third, 1 multiplied by 1, 0 multiplied by 1, 0. 0 multiplied by 1, 0, and the 1 multiplied by 0, 0. So you will get the 110 as a code. So your C2 code will be 001, your message bits, and 110 as your parity bits. So in this way, you can calculate the all code words C1 to C8, its message bit for 3 times 0 to the 3 times 1, parity bits 000 to the. So you will get the, if you check the first parity and the last parity, it is same. So the second one and second last, it is the same. Third one and third last, it will be same. Fourth one and fifth one, so it is the same. So it gives you the mirror image in the code word. So it is a systematic linear block code. The minimum humming distance, the weight of the code you can calculate, the 000 parity bits, so these two combines. So this is your 6 bit code word. So 6 times 0, so the no weight, so dash. So the weight is nothing but the humming weight, or weight is nothing but the number of ones present in the code word. So in this code word, so 3 ones are here, so the weight will be 3. In this code word, for the C3, the 3 weight is available. So for the C4, 4 1 is present, so the 4 weight, again 3, again 4, 4 and 3. So in this way you can calculate. So in this table you can find the 3 is the minimum humming weight present in the table. So the minimum humming distance, d minimum is equal to 3. So the humming distance is useful for the error detection and correction capability. So for the error detection, d minimum is greater than or equal to s plus 1. S is nothing but the error detection capability of linear block code. So 3 is the d minimum distance greater than or equal to s plus 1. So s is less than or equal to 2. So it can detect, so we can call it, conclude that the it can detect the 2 bit error because s is less than or equal to 2, right? Next one, error correction capability, d minimum is greater than or equal to 2t plus 1. So 3 greater than 2t plus 1. T is nothing but the error correction capability. So t is less than or equal to 1. So we can call it as conclude that the it can correct the 1 bit error. Next, the we have to calculate the parity check matrix. So parity matrix is already given. So parity check matrix formula is the p transpose colon I of n minus k. So p transpose means whatever the row can be converted into the column. So first row is 101, so it becomes the first column. Second row is 011, so it becomes the first or second column. Third row is 110, so it becomes the third column. I of n minus k, n is nothing but the 6 and k is nothing but the 3. So 6 minus 3 is 3, I of 3. So it is identity matrix of 3 by 3. So identity matrix is already, you know that the in the diagonal there is a 1 and upper diagonal is 0 and the lower diagonal part is also 0. So you will get the H, P transpose and I of n minus k. So P transpose is already calculated. So copy as it is and identity matrix. So you will get the here the parity check matrix. In this way you can calculate the parity check matrix. After that, the error syndrome. So syndrome is calculated. So received bit vector, it is given into the problem, and H transpose. Again, transpose of H means transpose of parity check matrix. That is whatever the row will be converted into the respective column. So the first row is 101, 101. So the first column will become 101, 101. Second row is 0 1 0 1 0. So second column will be 0 1 0 1 0. Third row is 1 1 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 0 1. So you will get the H transpose, or R is given into the problem 1 0 0 1. So multiply in your regular matrix multiplication and added with the module 2 addition. So you will get the 110 as a syndrome. So match this call row with the H transpose matrix. So it indicates that the third row is same as it is your syndrome row. So 110, it placed at the third position. That is first row position, second row position, and third row position is 110. It indicates that the in the received bit vector there is a third bit error correction, or there is an error in the third bit. So error in the third bit, so your received vector is 1 0 0 1 and error will become 0 0 1 0 0. So by simply adding these two, you will get the corrected code word is 101011. So corrected code word is 101011. Thank you.